early morning session here. Very early morning session because woke up early, 5 a.m. This tremendous dream that was so agitating and so difficult. And I went to work, asked the Holy Spirit, help. This is just extraordinary, this dream. And I got the help I needed. Got up, went outside. It was like totally dark. The stars were, the moon was big and the stars were bright deep in the heart of Texas that we're in. The Bay Area here. And eventually I got the paper. I said, oh, Jerry Brown, good old Jerry Brown, signed the Right to Die initiative here in California. Well, guess what? Last night I signed the Right to Not Die initiative. So be Holy Spirit, be good old Jerry Brown, the liberal ego continuity fear people to the punch here. How? Okay, so what did the Holy Spirit tell me to about this extraordinary dream? Very, very, very important video here, folks. I'm just sort of, it's your morning cup of coffee. Where's the, interesting. Well, I cannot adjust the, anything here. It doesn't need adjustment. It's great. Now, the neither nor practice, which I said is so important, the neither nor practice. Well, it came to the rescue again, and oh boy, is this important. And I'm going to explain it to you. I cannot explain the dream exactly, because it really was the dream of this world and what's going on in this world. And it's so intense, so intense. And I said, Holy Spirit, wow, what do you suggest? And says, Holy Spirit said, okay, got to practice here. He said, I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor do I choose to accept that truth is not true. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor do I choose to accept that truth is not true. Okay, I'll dial this down a little bit here. And that's the practice. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor do I choose to accept that truth is not true. Okay, so setting the tone for this video. Setting the tone here. We're in a brisk pace here, as we should be, because, you know, we're ready for, we need to get ready quickly, and the intensity is with us right now. We'll all be planning on a route we're going to take real soon. We're waxing down our surfboards. We can't wait for June. We'll all be gone for the summer. We're on for safari to stay. Tell the teacher we're surfing USA. You know, Haggerty's and Swami's, Pacific Palisades, San Onofre and Sunset, Redondo Beach, LA, all over La Jolla and at Waimea Bay. Everybody's gone surfing USA. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da. And that's right. We can't wait for June, man. I mean, we are planning out a route we're going to take real soon. We're waxing on our surfboards. We can't wait for June. We'll all be gone for the summer. On for safari to stay. Yeah, Beach Boys still my favorite band. I mean, that song just captured our childhood and turned me into a surfer and everything else. I mean, it was just Beach Boys in the early '60s, California. They just knocked it out of the park. It's unbelievable, but very meaningful lyrics, because we're prepping for June. We're going on safari, like a surf safari. You know, this is great. Getting out of school. What's the school? Well, the school of this world. How do we do this? Say, I choose neither to accept the truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. I choose to neither accept that truth is true, nor accept that truth is not true. I choose to neither accept that truth is true, nor accept that truth is not true. See, this is my choice. I choose to accept, I choose to neither accept that truth is true, nor accept that truth is not true. Okay. This is the great neither nor practice the Holy Spirit has given out at this time for us to help us. And indeed, after experiencing this dream, I can say that this is essential. It is essential that we start practicing in this way. And it is explainable to a certain extent. Let me get a little something to drink. You can say, I choose to neither accept the truth is true, nor that truth is not true. I choose to neither accept that truth is true, nor accept that truth is not true. Okay, where does that leave us? It leaves us in defining the issue as a choice between is either truth is true or truth is not true. It defines the issue for us. It defines the problem. Okay. And this is the only issue, the only problem. This is it. We say, well, but we don't make the final choice. But we do choose to define what the problem is. Okay. This is why it works so tremendously well. I choose to neither accept that truth is true nor that truth is not true. I neither choose to accept that truth is true nor accept that truth is not true. I choose to neither accept that truth is true nor accept that truth is not true. Or you can say, I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. You can say it in this way. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. So what we're saying is I'm not choosing. I'm not making the choice, but I am defining what the choice, what I'm choosing between. I am accepting that I have to choose between these two options, and that's it. But I'm not making the choice yet. This is what is crucial. This is called the intermediate step that gets us out of this dilemma of the world. The world is just a hoax. It's a fake crisis. We're all crisis actors here. The world is the ultimate crisis actor. It's a hoax. It's totally fake. I saw this in the dream. It was extraordinary, this dream. And, woke me up at 5 in the morning. I'm so stressed out from it. Holy cow, all this wheeling and dealing and blaming someone else and then shifting the blame and then just this nightmare, of how do we fix the problems of the world, all this stuff. And yet I was in the whole thing. I said, wait a minute, who am I? Who am I that is watching all of this, that is experiencing all of this? And I realized, actually, I'm the one who's inventing all these characters, these crisis actors who are playing all these roles. Who said, well, I'm going to fix it. No, it's someone else's responsibility. Now, let's make a deal. Let's split the responsibility. Wait, now, over here. And I was in this world. It was full of garbage and trash and toxicity. And we're in this little hotel. It was in little high ground there. And we're all these big wigs were there. And we're trying to figure out, what do we do with it? And who's supposed to take care of this? And who's supposed to clean this up? And wait a minute. And I realized that this is all an invention. It's all our imagination. Yet, we're not willing to yet choose that truth is true. This is too great of a leap. It's too great of a leap. So we feel stuck. But the Holy Spirit says, no, wait a minute. You don't have to be stuck. You can put yourself in a totally different frame of reference here than the struggle with the world. By saying, I don't even have to struggle with the world at all. I don't have to do anything about it. I know it's fake. I know it's a hoax. And yet, I feel stuck. Because I'm too scared to choose that, right, to accept that truth is true right now, you see. However, we can accept right now, we can accept that I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. We can accept this right now. We can accept this. And this then puts us in a totally different frame of reference. It puts us where the issue really is, where the problem really is. The problem is really not with the world at all. It's not with the world. That's a hoax. The world is a hoax. Okay, it's a 100% hoax that we have imagined. And all this struggling of who's responsible, who's supposed to be take responsible, who's supposed to fix this, who did this, who did that, and making the, oh my God, the conflicts and the power struggles and all this nonsense, all crisis actors, it's all invented to, completely invented. These people, we've invented people. We invented the world. We invented people. The world is a hoax. People are a hoax. Okay. Plain and simple. Saw it in the dream. I experienced it. And yet, I'm saying, well, what the heck can I do about this? I'm not sure. Holy Spirit came to the rescue. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. Okay, I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor do I choose to accept that truth is not true. So what we're saying is here is, hey, I'm choosing now to accept that this is the issue. This is the real issue. The world is not the issue. This is the issue. This is called repentance. This is the step of repentance. But I'm not yet choosing which way to go. Either accept truth or reject truth. I'm not saying which one I'm going to choose, but I do realize there's one choice that needs to be made and one choice only. That's it. Now, this puts us in a place where we don't even need a hoax of a world and a hoax of people. The people hoax, the world hoax. We don't even need it, because that's not the issue anymore. The issue is, you know, making this choice between choosing that truth is true or truth is not true. You know, choosing between those two positions. That's the real issue we have here, actually. And we're just delaying it. We're afraid of that, so we perpetrate this hoax of a world and a people. But when we accept that this choice is all that really needs to be looked at, that's all. I don't need to be distracted from it. I can accept not to make a choice right at this point, but to choose to accept that this is the choice that has to be made. This is like called the intermediate step. Intermediate step. It's like a ticket to paradise, actually. It's not demanded. God doesn't demand that we choose right now or else, you know, forget it. No, God just says, hey, first accept and accept, realize that, oh, this is the choice I have to make. And that's it. There isn't anything other choice. I can either, you know, choose to accept the truth is true or say no, reject that and say, no, I choose to believe that truth is not true. This is the only choice we have to make, actually. So accepting this is what we call repentance. It is repentance. This is what God says we must do. We must come to this point. And then from this point, this changes the whole situation. Again, we don't need a hoax world, hoax people, hoax world, crisis actors, crisis world. The world is the ultimate crisis actor. The universe is a crisis actor. We don't need it. We don't need that. We can have a situation that there is no problems at all, because we don't need any distraction. We repented. So this is the great breakthrough, awesome breakthrough this morning, to see this in context, in full context of this extraordinary dilemma I was trapped in, and thinking, how am I going to resolve? Who is going to clean up this massive, impossibly huge ocean of trash and garbage and toxicity and pollution, and who's going to... And I just said, hey, wait a minute, you know, I'm just imagining all this, but how do I stop imagining, you see? And I thought, well, I have to keep imagining and fix this problem. And the Holy Spirit said, no. Just accept, shift the whole thing to the level where the problem really is. So I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor accept that truth is not true. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. Okay, so what's important, we start out in the negative saying, which reassures us, like, oh, okay, I don't have to accept that truth is true. So this takes that burden off our mind, because that's the continuity fear burden that we have. That's why we say the neither nor is more powerful and effective, because we're frightened out of our gourds to say, how do we fix this problem with this? It just seems to be an absolute nightmare here in this world now. And it is. It is. The crisis, you know, actor of the world and the people, it's to the boiling point now. And of course, as we know, false flags distract us from something. They either pin blame, false blame on somebody else, or they're just a distraction device, okay? So sometimes a lot of false flag situations arise they're intentionally perpetrated here in this world to draw attention away from something else. So if there's something real embarrassing to the the powers that be, they will decide, hey, let's get this crisis going here, knock the other thing off the front page. You know, everybody's focused on, oh my God, look at this, a shooting, terrible shooting, gun control shooting, and they lose sight of something that could be extremely embarrassing, you know, and revelatory to the hoax nature of what's going on in the world. So they have these diversionary tactics. Of course they do. Call that a different definition for a false flag, but you can call it that. But we don't have to worry about any of that, because this is not the issue at all. This world's totally made up. It's a complete hoax. Total hoax. And when you see that, then you get frightened. You say, well, my gosh, what do I do? So we have this neither nor practice. So you're able to accept that the world and people are just a complete hoax when you're able to do this neither nor practice like this. I neither choose to accept the truth is true, nor choose to accept the truth is not true. I neither choose to accept the truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. So I do this out of necessity, because the intensity of this, you know, hoax, world people hoax, is so intense right now that you just want to get away from it. You know, this is what people are feeling, right? I just want to be quiet. I just want to go in, you know, I want to go into a fetal position. I want to go into a cave and just, you know, I can't take anymore. Yet this neither nor practice, this puts you in a positive place. And as you more and more accept this, you say, wow, I don't have to make the final choice right now. I just need to acknowledge that there is a final choice I need to make, but I don't have to make it right now. How about that? How about that? This is what is so awesome. This is what is so awesome about this. Yes, there is one choice I do have to make, but I don't have to make it now. But as long as I accept there's one choice to make, I don't need the world. I don't need the people hoax, world hoax. I can have the, you know, like I said, I signed the Holy Spirit had me sign the right to not die bill. The right to not die bill. Getting back to Jerry Brown, I could make some nasty jokes about him, but if I started that, where would I stop? You know, so I better not even start. Oh, God, assisted suicide. Now everybody in California can commit suicide, you know, as long as they get a doctor to say it's okay. That ain't the way. I mean, what are they, you know, the progressives in the world, what they are is they're proud that they don't ask the Holy Spirit. They're very proud of this fact. Says, no, I think for myself. I don't need to ask the Holy Spirit anything. I can think for myself. Well, of course, that's just the ego talking. That's the ego saying, I can think for myself. It's continuity fear talking is all it is. Because anything that is not given to continuity fear is automatically given to the Holy Spirit. So there's no such thing as I'm thinking for myself, meaning I'm not influenced by continuity fear. This isn't continuity fear talking. This is me, whatever, you know, some imaginary self that is neither truth nor continuity fear talking. Yeah, there's only one self, and it's in continuity fear speaks insanely about the one self, okay? But there isn't some other selves talking. So the progressives are just, you know, cuckoo, saying, oh, I'm so proud that I'm thinking for myself. I don't have to ask the Holy Spirit about anything. It's like, so now they're proud to have legal suicide. But, you know, we've just passed the bill, and I signed the bill. The right to not die. How about that? The right to not die. Legal non-death. Legal eternal life. The right to eternal life. The right to not die. And when we choose that, hey, I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. That puts us in a totally different boat, doesn't it? That puts us in a totally different boat. Do you get this? Are you getting it? We're in a different boat. We're in a cruise ship, beautiful cruise ship. You know, we're not on this tired old island here of egoic thought, continuity fear, the tiresome island. I call it the island of tiresomeness. tiresomeness everywhere here, isn't there? A totally tiresome island. We're not on the island anymore. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We don't have island fever anymore. We got off the island. We're in a different boat now. We're in a different boat. Beautiful cruise ship. Cruise the seven seas, you know what I mean? We're on a beautiful cruise now. We're not on this tiresome old island. We're in a different boat. Because we've accepted that we do have to make a choice ultimately, and we know what it is, and that's all there is to it. And yet we realize we don't have to make this choice yet. It will gradually dawn upon us at some point. We say, oh, okay. And then Jesus says that God actually takes the final step and says, okay, you're ready. But we don't have to take the final step yet. We can take this intermediate step, but just in a different boat. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. Don't need this tiresome old island anymore. Right? And all its hellish problems. Hoax problems. The whole thing is a complete hoax. 100%. And again, the waking up and realization of this is dependent on your willingness to do the neither nor practice. Otherwise, you're not going to see it. But if you practice neither nor practice and really get with it and really accept it and keep doing it, you will gain the capacity then to experience the hoax nature of this world and people, hoax nature of people, humans, human beings, all this. It's all a hoax. Human beings are a hoax. The planet, this planet Earth, Mother Earth, is a hoax. 100%. Crisis actress. But we use the generic term, covers both, you know, all acting. Crisis actor. The Earth is just a Mother Earth is just a crisis actor. Nothing more. So when you do the neither nor, then you can experience this, and then you say, oh, you ask the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit reminds you, do the neither nor practice. You do it, and then you realize, oh my gosh, I'm not trapped by this. I'm not trapped. But without doing this neither nor practice, you will not allow yourself to experience the hoax nature of this world, because you'll feel too stressed out by it. But I allowed myself to experience. I experienced this morning in a dream, and I woke me up and I said, holy cow, I need some help with this one. So I turned right to the Holy Spirit. I didn't turn to the ego or think for myself, you know, think for myself, which is the ego's bias. The ego said, well, think for yourself, meaning don't ask the Holy Spirit. Isn't that what the ego is saying when it's saying think for yourself? It's saying don't ask the Holy Spirit. But what did I do? I said, Holy Spirit, help. This is really intense here. And the help arrived, of course, neither nor practice. So I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. How about that? See, the different boat is completely different context of being a different boat, no longer on the island. So, you know, we're waxing down our surfboards. Absolutely we are. Can't wait for June to come here. We're just like thinking, wow, I just can't wait. June can't get here soon enough. Because that's when we're going on safari. Going on safari to stay. Tell the teachers we're surfing. Surfing USA. Haggerty's and Swami's. Pacific Palisades, San Onofrean Sunset, Redondo Beach, LA, all over La Jolla at Waimea Bay. Everybody's gone surfing USA. Starts out of everybody at an ocean across the USA, then everybody be surfing like California. You see them wearing their baggies, Hirachi sandals too, a bushy, bushy blonde hairdo, surfing USA. You see him surfing at Del Mar. And then it goes on. Santa Cruz and Trashels. A bunch of surf spots. So, all over Manhattan. And the Indohini way. tell it. Everybody's gone surfing USA. So we're going surfing, we're going surf safari. We got this cruise ship, great cruise ship, surfing safari, looking for great waves. How cool is that? What a song. When you're in school and you just can't stand school, and you think, man, I just could travel around the world just looking for surf spots, endless summer. That really struck a nerve in school kids at the time. California, it's like, yeah, the weather's like perfect. What am I doing at school? I could be surfing. Could I be wearing baggies and Arachi sandals, which are the sandals with tires on them, basically. Well, you know, back then they had these, they took tires, old tires, and you know, just used them as soles for sandals. Well, I had a pair of those, absolutely. I probably had a couple pair of them. Last a long time, it's great. I mean, that's all we really need, right? In California, Sriracha sandals, baggy surf trunks, and Sriracha sandals. Absolutely, that's what we wore. You know, threw some, you know, a white T-shirt on. That's it. That's your costume here. That was their costume. So we have this 9-month period now. And the intensity of this drama in the world, this hoax, this crisis hoax of a crisis, actually, entire world. I'm not pointing out anything in particular. It's the entire world, and everything that's going on is a complete hoax, spiritual hoax. But you will not experience this until you're practicing is very strong in neither nor practice. All right, so, but I'm just saying, once you get up to this neither nor practice, through, you know, it can take a while depending on where you're at. But I say, if you can accept this neither nor practice and really practice it, you may experience some very stressful dreams. Okay, because what happens is these dreams bring to light the hoax, are starting to bring the light, say, hey, something ain't right in the world. I can feel it. I'm experiencing these dreams. And then you do the neither nor practice and stabilize that. And then more can arise and more can arise until you finally start seeing, hey, this is all a hoax, attempt to produce a false memory for spirit. You know, it's complete false attempt to produce this false memory. It's a hoax. It's a hoax, a hoax, a hoax. And you'll be able to experience this, not just intellectualize. We're talking about experiencing it. In dreams, you experience, right? You feel it. You experience it. The intensity. I experienced the full intensity of the rigmarole in this dream, this hoax. It's just horrible. I said, God, how do I manage all this? This is a nightmare. We're just, and it goes on and on and on and on. You experience it. And then you practice this practice, neither nor practice. You know, and you have to be really willing to do it. Otherwise, you'll forget and try to figure it out for yourself. You go to the ego and say, ego, help. And they'll say, well, you can figure it out. You're smart. And I said, I don't think so, ego. This is beyond, this is, takes more than being smart here. There's something really screwy going on here. I'm the witness to all of this, and yet I'm also a party to it, and I feel like this is going to just go on forever. I don't think I'm smart enough to just figure it out intellectually like that. I don't think that's the answer, ego. And then you turn to the Holy Spirit, and it says, hey, neither nor. Give it a try. I neither choose to accept the truth as true, nor do I choose to accept the truth is not true. Hallelujah. And it puts you just feel, the stress is still lingering, but you recognize I'm in a different boat now. Really am. When we're able to apply this practice to this hoax issue, we're in a different boat. And it's dawning on me, you know, this is profound. This is profound. Now, let us tackle something slowly here. This is the little side issue. I don't even know if I need to tackle it or not, but maybe not. At some other point, I know I can explain it when it's necessary to explain it. Because ultimately, you have to go on intuition, the Holy Spirit, what it tells you to do. So, those who can do this will do it. It's very simple. Those who can do this neither nor practice will do it. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. Okay, to slow it down. I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. How about that for a great statement? Now, you cannot start out the spiritual path with this neither nor practice. We're too frightened. We're too still caught up in trying to manage this hoax somehow. And we're afraid that we can't admit that it is a hoax, you see. So we can't start out with admitting it's all a hoax. It's not possible. We're way too frightened for that. So, for example, Jesus, you know, can't, in his teaching, cannot just start out and just say, hey, folks, you know, just apply pure pragmatism to this right now and do neither nor practice. Yeah, that was, we'll just, it's outside the context of our understanding. We think that we have to believe in this world is true and the human beings are true and all this stuff. The only other option is to accept the truth is true. And we say, well, the continuity fear is way too strong. So there's no way that any teacher can just approach this. Any teacher whose job is to set out the big context of it and get it going, get the whole thing going, can teach this way. You know, it's up to the students to bring this to light, you know, not the root guru, the root teacher. They have to get the ball rolling, you see. That's the, and of course they know about this pragmatic step and everything, but they cannot start out that way and teach that, because they have to reassure you there's a path. It takes a while. So they have to lay it out like, hey, you can be liberated from suffering. There is a path. You know, you can start out, you know, feeling good and saying some nice affirmations and prayers, and you can work on this and these practices. They're not going to just start out with the ultimate practice and say, this is all you need. End of story. I mean, really, are they just going to say, hey, guess what? You can just say, I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth isn't true. This puts you in a different boat. This frees you from the complete hoax world, and bodies are hoax, the world is a hoax, and finished, you know, in a paragraph. They cannot do that. They cannot do that. That'd be irresponsible for a root teacher, you know, for like a savior like Jesus to teach in this way. But a student of Jesus can say this. Absolutely. Absolutely. Having gotten to pure pragmatism, you know. So it's not my burden to be the root teacher. Jesus says, I don't have that burden. Jesus has taken this burden on. Okay, so this helps us out. See, if we're willing to be students of Jesus, which I certainly am, a student of the Holy Spirit, you know, the Holy Spirit and Jesus have the burden, not us. So we don't have to lay out the full context and teach in that way, etc. We can just, you know, apply this pure pragmatism right here, right now, and put this in a different boat, and that's it. We're in the boat of paradise, really, in that boat. We're liberated from the hoax by doing that. Okay? So that's why it's very important to have this root guru, this root teacher, this, you know, it's very, very important. Very important. They carry the vast majority of the burden. Okay. Which is getting everybody started and reassuring them in that way. And yet, the whole thing is designed to get us to this neither nor practice, ultimately. Okay? Ultimately, it's all designed to get us to the neither nor practice. And so a student of Jesus can come out and say, hey, this neither nor practice works. It's worked for me. It'll work for you. And others who have advanced, you know, far along the path can hear this and say, hey, you know, wow, that's great. So again, the root teacher is not going to lay out this pure pragmatism as their foundation of their teaching. In just, you know, apply it right now, here, right now, that's it. They can't say that. They can point to it, they can intimate it, they can bring it up, but it's in a wider, broader, bigger context, okay? They have to get the ball rolling. That's the tough part. That's the tough part. See, it's a way bigger responsibility. They have to be, you know, totally sure of themselves to put themselves in that position. They have to be, you know, completely, you know, perfect acceptance of a truth is true. They have to have already accepted that truth is true in order to do that. Whereas we don't have to choose to accept that truth is true, make that choice yet. We just have to recognize that this is the only choice we need to make. That's our role. Okay. But someone like Jesus already accepted, made the choice, chose to accept that truth is true, nothing else is true. He's already done it. This is a different, you know, this is a savior. This is a different situation where they're able to then put out a broader context that's able to help people get started on the path. They're able to do that. So that's why you don't see here Jesus just saying, you know, just do this, that's it. Nothing else. I don't need to say anything else. And why I can just say, just do this, because Jesus has already said everything else, basically. So I can just say, just do this. See? And that's helpful, too. That's helpful. Absolutely helpful. Very interesting how it works. You have the great teacher laying out the full context, and you have students of the great teacher saying, hey, look, ultimately this works, and you can finish this way. We'll put you in a different boat. You don't have to make the final choice, actually. You just have to choose to accept that the parameters of the choice. That's it. And say there's no other choice that needs to be made. No other choice needs to be made. It's just one choice. And I'm consciously choosing not to make that choice yet. But I'm also consciously choosing to accept that this is the only choice that needs to be made. You see that? So I'm both choosing not to make this choice now and choosing to recognize it's the only choice I need to make. Both, right? See, that's a way of using the both practice too. I'm both choosing not to make the choice yet and choosing to recognize that it's the only choice I need to make. And then this puts us again in a different boat, which is what we want, right? Absolutely is what we want. That's success. We don't want to be on the boat of this tiresome old island here. We don't want to be, you know, trapped on this tiresome island, this hoax island. We want to be in this beautiful cruise ship, on vacation, on surf, you know, surfing safari. You want a surfing safari here. Going on a surfing safari. That's what they call it. Love that term. You just go to all the beaches around the world looking for surf, looking for waves, looking for surf spots. I know people that did this, still doing it their whole life. They go around the world, you know, looking for waves, surfing waves. Wow. But we got something even better than that now. I said, well, that's a nice metaphor, but let's get down to the real business here. Practice. You cannot just expect just a nice metaphor to be, you know, to get it done. We actually have to practice here. So, I neither choose to accept that truth is true, nor choose to accept that truth is not true. They're even finding waves out in the ocean now, huge waves at certain times. And of course, they use boats to get out to them, and then they use what do you call ski-doos or something that pull them into the wave, pull them into these gigantic 100-plus-foot waves, way out in some channel out in the ocean or somewhere. That's really that's the search for waves goes on and on. They'd surf tsunamis if they could, but you can't, because you can already see them. They might just be like a couple inches high in the middle of the ocean, but they're long, they're wide, and I mean they're deep as far as there might be a half an inch of a wave, but but that half an inch of a wave might go on for miles and miles, you know, like that. So the whole surface of the ocean has been raised up, and as it comes in the shore, it starts hitting reefs, it starts slowing down. The front part of that half inch wave starts slowing down, but the rear part of it is still going fast. And so what does that do? It starts pushing up the wave. So now it's a foot high over half a mile maybe, and now it's, you know, 10 feet high over a quarter over a quarter mile or something. And then it gets, you know, it as it gets closer to shore, it keeps getting pushed up. As the front keeps slowing down, the back keeps getting pushed up. Dissipating a sneeze there. But that shows you how tsunamis work, how problems pile up in this world, right? So the tsunami model is really a model for the problems of this world. So we may be looking around and say, well, I don't see many problems. But if you realize the earthquake has happened, you realize there is a tsunami moving, and it's just like a couple inches high where we are. We might just a slight little rise. Say, what was that? You know, but we hardly notice it because the rise lasts for a mile or so. It might last for a minute or something. I don't know. But as it gets closer and closer and closer to land, as it were, to law, to the wheels, to all this, suddenly it starts building up until at the shore there's this huge, you know, huge tsunami that's just flooding in, you know, flooding in like that, flooding, 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 flooding. It's a sign of the times, severe flooding, like in the Carolinas right now. All over the world there's severe flooding. We may get it in California this year. Sign of like a psychological tsunami is coming in the world. Absolutely, Agenda 21 is like a tsunami. All right, and as it starts to hit landfall, pile up, pile up, pile up, it's a disaster, you know. It's a crisis. Again, this whole world is a hoax crisis. Crisis hoax. False flag designed to distract us away from this choice that we're thinking we have to simply make. You know, it's either or. We there's no intermediate step. We have to either continue with this hoax or choose that truth is true. Like, it's either one of the two. And the whole thing about the Holy Spirit is saying, no, there's an intermediate step. Intermediate step, intermediate step, intermediate step. First, choose to recognize the choice that needs to be made. And that's all you need to do. That's enough, that's enough, that's enough. So I neither choose to accept the truth is true, nor choose to accept the truth is not true. This is enough. I'm excluding all other choice, all other, you know, thoughts and focus, whatever. Nothing else is on my plate. That's the only thing on my plate. Everything else is off my plate now. This doesn't mean you're in a different boat. But I don't have to choose, make the choice. I don't have to make this choice now. Because there's too much continuity fear involved in that, so we need to have some experiencing that will evaporate that remaining continuity fear for us. And this world may not give us that experience. We'll see. Jesus says it is possible to accept a different perception of the world. That's everything seems beautiful. No reason to doubt that. I haven't experienced that, but if he says so, then it is so. But but I've also experienced the death-free realm, different places to dwell, And that certainly provided an experiencing which would resolve the continuity fear, I feel, as far as making this choice. But that God ultimately makes the choice. You're ready. God basically says it. You're ready. So, in one way or another, it's God that will determine when we're ready. Okay, so our role is just to say that I do accept that this is the only choice, really, that needs to be made at all. There's nothing else. Puts us in a different boat. We'll see what happens now. I mean, I'm open to find out what happens. I'm not going to pin it down to this has to happen this way or that way or whatever. I'm just saying I'm doing my part, and I know the Holy Spirit will do its part, whatever that turns out to be. I don't know what it's going to turn out to be, and I'm not really worried about it one way or the other. My job is to practice. I neither accept the truth is true nor accept that the truth is not true. I neither choose to accept the truth is true nor choose to accept the truth is not true. Hey, I had my first kale smoothie last night. It was fine. I get frozen fruit. You can buy frozen fruit now, mixed frozen fruit for smoothies, and then I put in some kale in there. Didn't even taste the kale, so it was great. The sweetness of the fruit somehow masked the kale. So I'm gonna this morning I had goji berries and dried blueberries. I put those in there along with it. So that's my breakfast. But not much of a breakfast, so it seems like I could live on that because I don't lose weight. Unless I completely starve myself, nothing happens. If I eat, I gain weight. You know, if I starve myself, I might lose a little bit of weight. So going more to a liquid diet now. Throw in the spinach, throw in the kale. You know, it's okay. It's okay. Not bad. Just don't throw too much in. Stretching, flexibility. We'll see what else happens today. But I need to make this video. It's so important now. So important. It's full on. I mean, there's a preliminary UN meeting in October, late October, maybe the last week, around the last week of October, which is gearing up for the climate conference in December in Paris, which is super important. So this meeting in October is to prepare the papers and see what they've got and know exactly what it is, how much progress they've made, and set final parameters for what they're planning to vote on and agree upon in Paris in December, which will then provide the ultimate push for the July Sustainable Development meeting, high-level policy meeting or some high-level policy forum, HLPF, something like that, which it's going to now start the progress reports for the world. This is the beginning of the progress reports, and this kicks off the dystopian nightmare that is coming here. Progress reports. Everyone has to have a system in place for monitoring their citizens and get that going. And then there's every 5 years they're supposed to have again a major, you know, progress report. But they'll institute all sorts of other meetings and, you know, updates, etc. What they're doing is just laying out the basic outline of the blueprint and the will and kicking it off and stuff. So we have this October, we have the December, we have the July. Those are already in the pipeline going to happen for their way of dealing with this hoax, which is to say it's not a hoax at all, which is to say human beings are real, people are real, this world is real, and we have a real problem and all this stuff. You know, they're hoax deniers, basically. Truth deniers, hoax deniers. But we're not stuck with that because we have this neither nor practice, which enables us to recognize it's a hoax without feeling that we need to choose to accept that truth is true. You see, we've found this intermediate step now. We've found our game. this is what Jesus wants us to do. And this is, that's what he's been pushing me. Go, 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 go. You gotta find your game before, you know, this UN, this progress report thing kicks off, and the world's gonna put the pressure on everybody to accept that the people are real, that this world is real, that there's no hoax at all. This is all really happening. And it's not that measurements that scientists take and stuff, these measurements aren't being measured. It's that the entire thing is a hoax. The whole world is a hoax. Okay? This is very important, not losing sight of the forest because you're obsessed with the trees, obsessed with taking measurements. When you're measuring a dream, what importance do dream measurements have? You're measuring a hoax. You know? I mean, what importance does these measurements ultimately have? We can, you know, in this dream, as I was dreaming the toxicity of the world and the garbage and the hideous, you know, cesspool, have to clean it all up. And I said, wait a minute, I can just decide that it's gone and it'll be gone. It's not there. I can decide the world's perfectly pristine and it'll be that way instantly. But I said, I'm too scared to do that. You know, I'm too scared to accept that truth is true right now. So then I think, oh my gosh, then I'm still stuck with these problems. No, I'm not. I'm not. Because I can decide to neither choose to accept the truth is true nor choose to accept the truth is not true. I can make that choice. And that is it that puts us in a different boat. And what that'll be like, I'm going to find out now. Going to find out. And I'm not really concerned about it. I know that this practice, okay, this is it. So, whatever it will be. I have faith in the Holy Spirit that somehow, you know, is going to dawn upon me what kind of boat this is. So, get on the boat. I'm on the boat now, but I don't really know what kind of boat it is exactly, but I'm sure it's a really great boat, and I'll find out, you know, bit by bit, but I'm not really focused on that right now. I'm just focused on, you know, getting on the boat and realizing I'm on the boat. I'm not really going to explore the boat at this point. And again, we will not experience this until we have this neither nor practice. That's why practice is so important. So I've emphasized practice over and over and over. Every video emphasizes practice. You have to have confidence in your practicing. Otherwise, you cannot psychologically handle experiencing the hoax nature of the world as I did in the dream. I experienced it. I was aware of it. I said, wow. I can either accept this world is real or accept it's a hoax. I can go either way with this, I realize. I can go either way. But deep down, I know that it really is a hoax. I mean, I'm the one who's just imagining all these crisis actors, all this crisis action. Hoax action. I could just say the world's perfect and it would be perfect instantly. I could just decide this is what I want to experience. I don't need to get rid of the pollution. I can just imagine a world that doesn't have any. I can just imagine it's not there and it's gone because it's a hoax. It's just my imagination. It's just my imagination. Spiritual imagination I'm talking about here. Not human person imagination. Spiritual imagination. Who is the one that is witnessing all this? That's the one that's imagining all of it, actually. But we're afraid, you know, we're afraid to realize that, accept this fact. So, but we don't have to choose to accept that fact. We don't have to actually make the choice of, you know, it's gone instantly. You know, we don't have to accept that yet. But we do have to realize that this is the the acceptance that we do have to ultimately choose between whether I accept it or not accept this, whether the truth is true or not true. So I'm neither choosing to accept the truth is true nor choosing to accept the truth is not true. So I'm not burying the issue at all. So the issue is front and center now. Obviously, I've seen it's a hoax, but so we're just setting this whole thing aside. You know, it doesn't really have to be. Really, we don't have to struggle with the world anymore. It's not necessary to struggle with the hoax anymore. That's no longer the issue. We've already realized, of course it is, but I'm not willing to completely set down, you know, perception. I'm not willing to. What I'm not willing to do is see it change like this instantly, like that. I'm not really willing to apply it in that way yet. That's too much of a leap. So again, I'm not exactly sure how it's going to work out, but I'm sure I will find out one way or the other. So it's questionable, you know, whether we'll actually experience it here in this world, like, oh yeah, everything's perfect, there's no problems here in the world at all, or we'll experience a problem-free world that isn't, that we feel like, well, it's not necessarily this world. Because this world is so insistent now on all these problems, you know, it's pretty difficult to be in this world and just to say, hey, there are no problems, everything's perfect. I don't know. This is theoretically it's possible. Ananda, my mom, was in the world. She insisted that everything's perfect, there are no problems. World War I was raging. World War II was raging. The famines are raging. Smallpox, cholera, epidemic. You know, all the problems of Vietnam War. She said, there are no problems, everything's perfect. What are you talking about? I need to fix something. There's nothing that needs fixing. Everything's perfect. Well, this is going to be quite difficult to assert this at this point in time, right? And she just shrugged off criticism by saying, well, I'm a little bit cuckoo, but, you know, I can't do anything about it. But that's a savior talking. I mean, we're not these savior uber gurus, you know? And we don't have to be. So it's questionable as whether or not we're going to be in like that, you know, but I'm open-minded. If that comes about that way, fine. But I'm also open-minded to the fact that it may not come about that way. It's possible too, right? Because the intensity, I mean, you look at the poll in California for the right to die. I was shocked. It's like, what, 70-something percent agree that, you know, with the right to commit suicide, and only like 20, a low 20s or something, are against suicide, assisted suicide. I said, what? Baba thought of it just the opposite. So this is quite stunning for me. I am really shocked to see that the vast majority of Californians agree with assisted suicide. But of course, it's only like Washington, Oregon, California, and Vermont that now have this law. The rest of the country still has some sanity. They still believe that there's the Holy Spirit, you know, and that need to ask the Holy Spirit what to do. But yeah, I mean, these uber liberal states, Washington, Oregon, California, and Vermont, have said, of course, you want to die? You say, I don't want to feel like I'm too stressed out. Go to a doctor and say, doc, I can't bear to live any longer. Now, of course, there's some parameters but you know how it goes in liberal states. They keep fudging it and fudging it and fudging it and fudging it and greasing the skids. I mean, what if you're a kid and say, you know, I'm so stressed out, I feel so sad, I hate this world, I don't want to live here anymore. I have all this mental disease and mental problems, and go to a doctor. I mean, what are they going to say? I mean, there's some age limit. You got to be old for this. Or can you be young too? Because of course, if you're really, you can develop any sort of illness, symptoms you want in the body. It's all a hoax. This whole thing's a hoax anyway. So what's to stop somebody from hoaxing an illness? All illness is hoax. It's all hoaxing. Cancer is a hoax. Every disease is a hoax. Even being born is a hoax. The whole world's a hoax, actually. So what's to stop anyone from just hoaxing something at any age? Say, oh yeah, okay, I just want to hoax this and go to the doctor, and the doctor say, okay, here's the drugs, kill yourself. Commit suicide. You know, it's a completely slippery slope that they've gone down. Completely. And of course, Jerry Brown says, well, I really put great thought into this. You know, well, really? I mean, I don't think he asked the Holy Spirit about it. But you can't really blame Jerry Brown, because 70% of the population want it. I'm not saying Jerry Brown's a terrible person. I mean, I don't really know one way or the other. He tends to try to govern wisely, is what he does. So if the people want something, he'll sign it. You know. So it's the people of California, 70 plus percent, want this. I don't know if Jerry Brown really wants it or not, but he views his role as governor as being pragmatic. If the people want it, then he's not going to, you know, stand in their way. He doesn't view himself as a religious role. It's a secular political role is what he's, you know. So he may not in himself agree with it. I don't know. But what a shocking, shocking, shocking thing this morning. Again, but it's fine, because we have the right to never die bill. Yeah. I've already signed that bill. The right to never die bill. I have a right to never die. I have the right to recognize that death is a hoax bill. Sign that bill. I already signed that bill. It's spiritual law. Signed into spiritual law by accepting it, right? I have a right to take the intermediate step between this massive hoax and reality, right? And dropping this hoax, right? This hoax looks so massive, I have the right to take this intermediate step where I don't have to say that I can choose between lies and truth. I can choose to accept what the choice is without yet making the choice. See? So I can accept the intermediate step between this massive, massive hoax and reality. At the same time, choose to accept to never die. I can choose that. And I'm a Californian too. See, that's the other side of California. Flipping the script, Californians. See, not all Californians are liberal wackos, you know. Some of them have been listening to the Holy Spirit. We're not all knee-jerk liberals here. Although you'd be hard pressed to find any that aren't. You know, it. But yeah, we still, you know, a few, I guess, at least one here, at least one. Californians, you know, we're unorthodox. We think outside the box. So, but you get some that, you know, are like total egotist. They only listen to the ego, and the ego says, yeah, think outside the box, meaning don't go along with the Holy Spirit, what anything is said. That's how they view thinking outside the box. Whereas I view thinking outside the box as don't go along with the ego, think outside the box of egoic continuity fear, which, in other words, listen to the Holy Spirit really carefully, you know, better than before. So this is intermediate ground where people have not really listened to the Holy Spirit very carefully, and then the liberals and the egotists come in and say, hey, you know, you don't seem really smart. You could be a lot smarter if you listen to us, and we're thinking outside the box of the Holy Spirit. And then people get sucked into this, you know, delusion, the progressive liberal delusion of thinking that they're being progressive and smart, because they're abandoning the ground of not vagueness, fuzziness. Now they're real clear. Oh yeah, I'm clearly following the ego. How smart I am. But it's not smart at all. Following the ego is not smart at all. Because it's you know, hoax denier. You turn into a hoax denier is what happens. Now, I don't know if all these small little things that happen in the world, whether they're hoaxes or not, that's not the point. The point is to see that the entire world is a hoax, actually, and that human beings are a hoax. There's no such thing as a world, actually, or human beings. There's only spirit imagining all of this as an attempt to perpetrate a false memory upon itself so it can claim that's not really what it is. So we have the right to this intermediate step. We have the right to this boat, this wonderful cruise boat. We have that right. And that's just a pragmatic thing too, right? So I'm pragmatically governing also here, self-governing here. Yeah, I'm a governor of myself, being self-governing, choosing to listen to the Holy Spirit and explain what our options are. I'm a constituency of one here, right? So I have the right to accept this governance. And say, oh, I have the right, I have a bill, the right to an intermediate step. I neither choose to accept the truth is true, nor choose to accept the truth is not true. I have that right to be in that boat. And I have the right to choose to never die. I have a right to choose eternal life, absolutely. I have a right to be so healthy, so perfect, I don't need to die at all. I don't even need doctors, right? I have that right too. So we need this bill of spiritual rights to be presented to us, start being aware of this. Hey, I have this whole bill of spiritual rights. Now, it's not really Jerry Brown's job to bring this to light. It's my job and others like me, okay? So that's why I didn't make any nasty jokes about Jerry Brown, but I'm sure that there's some that are. But it's not really right to do that, though. No. That's why I didn't do it. If Jerry Brown wants to come here and hear the spiritual bill of rights, he's welcome. He's welcome as anyone else. Everybody's welcome who wants it, wants to know this. Even the Pope and the POTUS, everybody here. If they want to be informed, then they have the right to be informed, absolutely. As long as they don't try to be disruptive. I mean, this is serious business here. We don't, you know, this is a privilege, I mean, here. And so, of course, we're not going to allow disruptiveness here. Everyone has to be on their utmost, you know, good behavior. I may have to eat more than that smoothie this morning, actually. You know, maybe I cannot live on a few smoothed out strawberries and peaches alone. I don't know. I don't know what else I'd eat. But getting up so early like this, I was up at 5 in the morning. Basically, what is it? It's already 9, 4 hours. Oh, well. Feel the pain, feel the hunger, it's okay. So, Surfing Safari, Surfing USA. Surfing USA, what a hit that was. That was like a big wave right there. Wow, everybody caught surf fever. A lot of people caught surf fever. I had to drive early this morning. It was dark, driving through the town, and all these police are cruising around looking for, make sure everybody's going, you know, it's a very slow speed limit. So I go on the speed limit. Of course, I'm not an idiot. Yeah, it's dark, slow speed limit. Police are cruising around looking, you know, for something to do. You don't want to go speeding through town under those circumstances. Only an idiot would do that. And so I'm doing the speed limit, like everybody else would, you know, sane person would do. And I got some yahoo on my bumper, you know, rear bumper. pressing me, pressing me, pressing me, pressing me, pressing me. Say, hey, I'm not gonna speed. Sorry. You know, if you want to speed, go around me, you know, and you get the ticket. Well, they wouldn't do that. They wouldn't go around me, which is it's a broken yellow line. They could have just gone around me, but then, you know, they might have gotten a ticket. It never occurred to them, maybe. There's nobody else on the street. There's this car right on my bumper. Come on, come on, come on, go, 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 go. And I'm saying, no, I'm not going, I'm not going, I'm not going, I'm not going, I'm not going to do that. In other words, intermediate step. I'm in intermediate step mode, and they're in either or mode. I'm in neither nor mode, and they're in either or mode. Okay, I gotta get to work fast. They must have been, you know, got up, jumped up, and like guzzled espresso. And so finally we get to this turnoff where they get to go down towards the freeway, and I'm going straight. And they, as they finally get around me on the right, you know, they're whizzing past me. They had to honk their horn. You know, like, you idiot, get out of my way. How dare you be in neither nor mode? I'm in either nor mode. Come on, I got to get the answer, either or mode. And so this is the difference. It's perfectly pointed out, right? The difference here in Silicon Valley, everybody's in either or mode. I'm in neither nor mode. Different boat. They think either we have to deny it's a hoax, or completely have the whole thing vanish like this. There's no other option. See, they're ignorant. They don't listen to the Holy Spirit. The ego will tell them, well, sure, it's either or. That's it. There's nothing else. Which guarantees that we'll stay in hoax denier mode, right? Guarantees it. Guarantees it. Nobody's going to leap from either or mode, just have the whole universe just disappear like that, you know? Forever. No. So by listening to the ego, we stay in either or mode instead of neither nor mode. And we stay hoax deniers. So I had this hoax denier on my tail this morning. But they couldn't pressure me to go faster. I said, I'm not going faster. Too bad you don't like it. Cut out, you know, next tomorrow try decaf. But the pressure here in the Silicon Valley is insane to go into full blast either or mode. Full blast either or mode. You know, I've seen people like just want to just pull out into traffic, across traffic. They say, I'm either, I can't stop. I mean, either or mode. Come on. I don't care. You shouldn't be in my way. You shouldn't be here, cars. This is the attitude here. The way they drive here is, well, I know you're there, but you shouldn't be there. And they're starting to drive that way of like, just like, well, I'm just going to pull out anyway. Oh, gee, you caused a huge accident. Well, you shouldn't have been there anyway. Shouldn't have been an accident, because you shouldn't have been there, because I'm too important. I'm in full blast either or. I'm a big honcho, either or honcho here. You know, either or honcho, CEO. I'm the CEO of either or land. Get out. You're not supposed to be here. And so, hey, you know, at some point we may not be here. The neither nor folks may just decide, hey, yeah, we're in a nice cruise ship. To heck with you guys. You know, we're going to go on a nice cruise and forget about you for a while. We're going to go on a surfing safari for a while. You know, tell the teacher we're surfing USA. Yeah, it's got to be like that, right? The either or folks and the neither nor folks, they got to go different ways, because the either or folks, they just can't, you know, they can't function anymore. They're becoming dysfunctional here. I swear to God, I told you before, I was going like 45 in this, you know, it's going perfect speed limit in this road. And somebody came out of the driveway, the CEO type in some real fancy car, and you could tell they're just, and they just wanted to pull right out. They didn't want to wait for me to pass the driveway. And I had to, I think I was, I had to like, we looked at each other and it's like, I think he honked or something. Like, he just didn't want me to be there. I inconvenienced him, like, you know, he wanted to just come out of his driveway and not have any traffic there at all. And just pull right out. He was going to pull right out. Well, that would, of course, cause a crash. But I saw that's in his mind. I don't know. I'm not sure if it's a he or she. It could be, though. Actually, the women here are just as bad as the men, if not worse. Okay, as far as aggressive driving goes. I had someone on my tail yesterday super aggressive driver. They just wanted me out of the way. It was coming off a freeway, from one freeway to another. And they kept trying to get around. Like, I want to get around. You shouldn't be. And the whole attitude was, you shouldn't be here. I'm in a hurry. And it was a woman. You know, you shouldn't be here. I'm in a big hurry. I'm important. I'm on the road to Shaman to see the goddess, you know. The goddess is waiting for me. Get out of my way. Not just get out of my way. You shouldn't even be here in the first place. Not car getting out of my way. Like, what? It's like, what is this car doing in my way? I don't understand this. This car should not be in my way. This is the kind of driving. I was trying to figure out, what is she doing? What is this driver doing? I mean, I'm doing this above the speed limit. I'm exiting off one freeway, going to the other on the exit ramp. And yet they're acting like somehow something's all wrong here. Like, I shouldn't even be there. Should not be a car in front of me. I don't want there to be a car in front of me. There shouldn't be one here. This is the mentality of Silicon Valley now, folks. I kid you not. I kid you not. I'm cutting edge of news here, aware of this now, cutting edge awareness. Others will follow on a little later. You know, they'll sort of gradually start getting it. But this is what's going on. This is the mentality now. You shouldn't even be here. You shouldn't even be in my way. You don't. So you shouldn't even exist. And this will filter down to actual taking steps to say, you're a non-existent person, so why are you even here? Let's make you disappear. You know, Soylent Green. Soylent Green. This is their mentality. It's a very, they're mentally ill, okay, to say the least. To say the least. Yeah. People in Silicon Valley, the mindset, they're extremely mentally ill, but they don't realize it. They just think that you shouldn't exist. It shouldn't be in their way. And of course they think they're very wonderful folks. They're very healthy minded folks. They don't realize that either or mode goes into this extreme mental illness, whereas neither nor mode is headed towards this perfect mental health. Actually, it's the intermediate step to perfect mental health. But when you take someone who's extremely mentally ill in either or mode, they're not going to just go into perfect mental health forever and ever and ever and ever with no notion of it possibly being otherwise. That's way too much of a continuity leap for them. So they'll continue, and if they're ignorant of neither nor, then they'll stay in either or mode, okay? They'll stay in it, and they'll become worse and worse and worse. You get people trying to run you off the road. I mean, this is what's happening. They said, you shouldn't be here in my way. You're in my way, you shouldn't be in my way, therefore just vanish somehow. I guess I was expecting me to somehow, you know, just like get off the road, but I can't. I'm on this off-ramp of a freeway, there's nowhere to go, but they expect me to go somewhere. This is the trouble, right, isn't it? This is the trouble we're going to run into in this world. Imagine if you're on this ramp, it's off the freeway, you know, and it's like elevated ramp. There's nowhere for you to go. And yet these drivers expect for you to disappear. You shouldn't be in my way. What do we do about that? What do we do about these either or hoax denying mental illness, severe mentally ill folks here, you know, that are rapidly running around this world now, telling us that they have a blueprint for our future? Hey, thanks, but no thanks. I think I'll get on that cruise ship. I'll take a cruise, you know, ship. So how is it going to play out? Well, first you need to connect the dots. You know, by connecting the dots, then everything gets easier and easier and easier. Say, oh, so this is what's going on. I see. Wow. We usually see it first in California. This is ground zero here. And then the illness spreads throughout the world. You know, the plague. This is like ground zero for the plague, you know, actually, the plague of you shouldn't be in my way. So therefore, just disappear. I don't have time. Just disappear. I don't have time to talk to you. Just disappear. And these are these lovely liberals of California, you know, bringing this lovely mental illness to the world. They say, oh yeah, of course, just disappear. I mean, nobody should be in my way. I want what I want, that's what I want. And nothing should stand in my way. And if anything's in my way, well, it shouldn't be. So I should just get out of my way instantly. And how it gets out of my way, it's not my problem. It just I don't, you know, disappear, get out of my way instantly. And we'll, you know, pass laws to say, yeah, nobody should be in my way. because we're righteous, wonderful, progressive liberals who are in full either or mode, and we are hoax deniers. We're wonderful hoax deniers. And they call that mental health. And of course they're gobbling his pills like crazy. He said, well, that's just a sign of my awesomeness. It helps me cope with the fact that they're actually people seem to be in my way, or, you know, they shouldn't be in my way, but they are. I'm so upset and frustrated. I got to take all these pills. You know, they're not, you know, these people think that they might think the world's a hoax. What the heck are they talking about? This world's not a hoax. It's real. People are real. Everything's real, 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 real. And I want it to be the way I want it to be right now. And they're throwing tantrums out here, California. Tantrum Central. So this plague is infecting the planet. Now we got this, suicide for everybody bill, you know. Hey, everybody's free to take drugs and commit suicide. And, you know, they think, well, this is the only way I can handle the stress of this situation. My gosh, I want what I want, and I want it right now. And anything that's in the way shouldn't be in the way. It needs to vanish instantly. And if it doesn't, I just can't take it anymore. What? Either or, either or, either or. This causes suicide. Either or, either or, either or. Eeyore, you know? Eeyore, 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 either or. Yeah, what is Eeyore? Some kind of donkey or something? Well, there are a bunch of donkeys out here. Donkey minds. Donkey minds, yeah. Eeyore minds. Either or minds. Either or mindset. And I'm the neither nor mindset, you know, so I'm anomaly here, anomaly, 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 a wonderful anomaly. So we'll see what that anomaly brings now. Yes, we'll see what this anomaly brings. Absolutely. New table, right? Got a new table. We got the neither nor table. We're no longer dining at the either or table. We're dining at the neither nor table. So we'll find out what kind of wonderful delicacies are presented at this table. So I'm just sitting down at the table, you know. I don't know what's going to be brought to the table, but, you know, it's like you come into a restaurant and you really want to go to this restaurant, and you sit down, just sit down, here's a table for you, and you sit down, you kind of like say, wow, what's this going to be like? What, you know, what's this dining experience going to be like? It's like that. We went to a little restaurant recently, a little Vietnam pho soup, Vietnam restaurant, pho soup place. And it was a little tiny, small place. We sat down, and I was like, wow, I don't know. What's this going to be like? It's very simple and modest and just, you know, like, is this going to be good? I don't know. Well, it was great. Food was great. Pho soup was great. Everything was very nice, very fast service. That lemonade club soda thing was excellent. And yeah, it's fine. It's great. But this is an example. You come to a restaurant, you don't know. If you don't know what the food is, I didn't know what the food was going to be like there. No idea, really. So we're sitting at a table now. We sat down at the table. All right, next. The waiter shows up and said, what would you like to have? Or, this is what we have here. Here's the buffet. They got a buffet for you or something. We take whatever you like. Something like that. Or they're going to put a buffet there. And so you can get anything on the menus, but the whole menu is there, and just whatever you like from the menu, it's all here. Just take whatever you like. I don't know, but it's like that, sitting in a restaurant, not sure what kind of food's going to be brought, you know, but you know it's going to be tasty. So you're not really that concerned. That's how I feel. I'm not really that concerned. I'm not struggling. Wow, what's going to happen? Yeah, you know, let the waiter bring, you know, bring the food. Here's the hors d'oeuvres. Let's start with this. Let the waiter bring what the waiter wants to bring. Trust in the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit's the waiter. Is going to bring you the experiencing. And so, you know, let the experiencing come now. This is very exciting. Wow. Sitting down at a new table here, the neither nor table. table instead of the either or table. You get that? Are you starting to get the picture here? Using Silicon Valley as a great example of the either or mentality and how it's going insane. They're going insane here. How they'll spread, Sandy's been spread throughout the world. And they'll think nothing of extermination, actually, ultimately. That's how insane they're going, actually. And they're citing, they're already citing on self-extermination, right? This is not far step at all for them to decide that those that they are in their way to exterminate them too. It's not at all, in their mind, it's not a strong leap at all. They've already accepted, sure, this is great. I get to go to the doctor and commit suicide anytime I want to, really. If the people are bugging me too much, this either or problem is too much for me, I just take some drugs, I'm dead, wonderful. You know, that's for them, they say that's great. So how much of it is a leap towards saying, hey, wait a minute, the reason why I'm going to commit suicide here is because these people are not supposed to be in my way, or are in my way. And so if I just get them out of the way and make them vanish, then I won't have to commit suicide and I'll be happy. That sounds right to me. I can connect those dots. This is their mentality. The dots that in their mind, connecting the dots in their mind for them, they'll easily connect those dots. Very dotty. Or they say very potty-minded. Kind of lunatics. They are either or lunatics, This is the world that this is how the hoax is going right now. Got these either or lunatics thinking we know who should be on the road and who should not be on the road. And whoever's in my way shouldn't be on the road. I'll end up exterminating everyone, I don't want anybody on the road, I want to go 150 miles an hour. Anybody who's going any slower, they shouldn't be on the road at all. In fact, they should vanish instantly from the road. Because I'm in a hurry for this either-or thing. I got to fix this world's problems of the world, because I got to keep this world. I believe it's real. I believe people are real. I'm too scared to recognize it's a hoax, because then it'll have to disappear instantly. I have to accept truth as truth right now. No, they've been listening to the ego is the problem. If they listen to the Holy Spirit, different story, intermediate step. Hey, I can go the neither nor route. I neither choose to accept the truth is true, nor do I choose to accept the truth is not true. But I do choose to accept that this is the one issue that needs to be chosen, right? This is the issue where choice has to be applied. No other issue, no other problem, no other. This is the only choice that needs to be made. I can either choose the truth is true, or choose to keep believing that truth is not true, which is a belief system. If you choose the truth is true, there's no belief system needed at that point, right? But if you choose the truth is not true, then a belief system has to arise to believe that somehow reality's been changed, that truth has been changed. So this is the only choice there is. So I can choose to accept this is the only choice there is, but I can just say I'm not going to make that choice yet. Got it? I choose this is the only choice there is, but I choose not to make the choice yet. Keeping the back stretched out, trying to stretch out. So, very exciting situation, isn't it? We're sitting down at a table, a new table here. The neither nor table. We just left the either or one, and now we're sitting down at the neither nor table. What is the food going to be like? Stay tuned. So we'll let the waiter start delivering the food. What else can you do at this point, right? And, you know, you can follow along here and keep practicing. You can, you know, start out with the both this and not this, both this and not this. That's a milder form of it. Or you can do, I'm not a body, I'm free, I'm still spirit, exactly as God created me. All the different practices I've given out in the videos, you can do any one of those. And keep working on it, And at some point you may start going into the neither nor practice. You know, it's up to each one individually, depending on where they're at, right? You might not be able to do it right away, but you can still follow along with the effects of it. You know, what kind of food am I, what kind of experiences am I getting from the Holy Spirit? And this can help you. You can do the I can, I will, I've already done it practice. Like, I can do the neither nor practice. I will do the neither nor practice. I'm already doing the neither nor practice. You can practice in that way. But whatever you do, practice. See, this should be start coming apparent. The difference between the either or and neither nor, you got to be able to get to the neither nor practice. Otherwise, you're going to get in the way of those neither nor, those either or folks. Okay, who say you shouldn't be in their way. And they want you not to just get out of your way, but simply to vanish. You should never have been there in the first place, right? So you're going to get into that situation. And I don't advise anybody to get into that situation, all right? So practice. I've been hammering away at this for years. You know, you can't force anyone to practice. That's true. But it should become very apparent now. You know, maybe in your part of the world, it's not so extremely apparent. But I tell you, this either or from, that's coming from California, from the Silicon Valley, from technology, from the United Nations, it's a global push. And it's an either or push to be what? Hoax deniers. Being a hoax denier puts you in the either-or situation, and ultimately you will be labeled as getting in the way of those who want to go faster, and therefore they expect you just to just disappear out of the way. Not say, well, wait a minute, let me, you know, I'll eventually let you pass. No. And no more of that eventually. Once I get off the freeway on-ramp, you know, and then you can get on the freeway too, and then you can pass me, which is what they did. No. They say, no. You shouldn't have been here in my way in the first place. So just vanish, disappear, commit suicide, you know, be dead, be gone, get out. You know, you'll get caught up in that. And you see, these folks seem nice. They seem wonderful, nice people here. But they don't really seem that nice, actually. I mean, I'm just giving the benefit of the doubt. They don't really pay attention because, you know, you're in their way. Why are you in my way? But they seem functional, you know. They're functionally insane is what they really are. This world is really a place of functional insanity. However much you want to say functional. I mean, the insanity is functioning. The hoax is functioning. It's a functional hoax. Obviously, if there's a hoax that's being functioning as a hoax. So the people hoax, the world hoax, it's all fake crisis actors, it's all a hoax. But they're, you know, functioning as hoax deniers. You know, they're functioning that way. They seem like, well, you know, well, pretty normal people, but not really. You can tell by their driving that they're abnormal. Driving reveals a lot about someone. Absolutely it does. You can tell the mindset of a place by how people drive. If people are driving nice and slow and easy and everything's cool, then they're probably going into the, you know, the neither nor folks, you know, going in that direction, listening to the Holy Spirit. And they say, I don't have this freak out about either or. I don't have to be a hoax denier. I got this neither nor intermediate step. So I can look at the world, I can slow down and just say, hey, let me think about the world. Let me ask the Holy Spirit. Let me observe. Let me be observant. Let me slow down in the full stop in the wow. You know, I don't have to be driving 100 miles an hour. I can be driving 25. You know, that's good enough. You see, this shows the attitude, right? And I was driving the main street and I slowed down. I wanted to see something. I was slowing down at 5 miles an hour. I was looking like this. Because it was early in the morning. It's no cars at all. You know, I didn't have to keep going. So I slowed down, looking here, looking there, 5 miles an hour. But most people, you know, they won't do that anymore. Except some of the new drivers here from other countries know how to drive here. And they'll freeze up. It's not slowing down, it's freeze up. They go into freeze up mode. Like, oh no, I'm not sure where I'm going. I think I'm totally lost. I don't know where I'm going. Let me just stop. It'd be a good idea if you pulled off the side of the road if you want to stop like that. If you freeze up. Freezing up's a different story, right? But I've got people freeze up on the freeway. Everyone's doing 75, actually doing 90 now. And they'll just stop on the freeway. You know, just like, wait a minute. Where am I? What am I doing here? Where am I going? What's going on here? I say, hey, you know, the stop's okay. But maybe if you pulled off to the side of the freeway, you know, and stopped there instead, that would probably be a lot safer. I'm not mad with them stopping. If you freeze up, you know, you freeze up, but can you at least get off to the side of the road? That would be fine. No, I mean, it's Silicon Valley. I mean, you're doing 75, 80, and the people are doing 95, some are doing 100 now. You know, they want you out of the way. You shouldn't be in their way. How dare you even be on the road? Something's wrong with the universe. Obviously, you don't have the memo yet that they're important. They need to do 100. You know, they're in either or mode. They're in full hoax denier mode. They got to work hard to be hoax deniers. You know, and so, you know, anyone who's not a hoax denier shouldn't even be here. Well, what about the necessity to demonstrate and show to others that this is a hoax world and there is an intermediate step? They need that help. So you can't, you know, you can't just say, you know, it's like on a battlefield, no medics, I don't want any medics. What is this medic doing on the battlefield? Well, you know, you need medics on a battlefield. They don't want to run the medics out of this place. They don't want to run those who are aware of truth, you know, aware of the neither nor practice, you know, intermediate step. You don't want to run them out of here. You don't want to run those who are practicing this out of the world. I mean, you don't want to run the help out of the world. I mean, if you're extremely insane, you don't want to run all the therapists out of the world. They got no time to think about stuff like that. This hoax denying thing is a very intense effort, you know. It takes all their effort. They gotta make more effort. Always more effort. Good Lord, they gotta make sure everyone's being monitored for signs of, you know, make sure that they're all good hoax deniers, you know. Make sure nobody's waking up and saying, hey, wait a minute, this is a hoax. Whoops, you've got to take your meds this morning, huh? Got to keep those brain waves monitored at all costs. And again, this is not, I'm making light of it, I mean, humorous, because it is, you know, we need to be this way, and we can afford to, being sitting at a different table now, you know, kind of say, hey, aren't we happy we're not sitting at that old table, you know? And, you know, it's sort of so bad you want to joke about it. You know, why not? Why not? Since it's over with, might as well laugh about it. Might as well. Yeah, you know how people joke when they're out of some terrible, stressful situation? They like to joke about it and make jokes because, you know, what, it's better than looking back and saying, oh, it's so terrible, so awful. No, you'd be happy that you're free of it now. And so, you know, you're not going to be all morose about how terrible things used to be when you're in a great situation now. What's the point of that? So you might as well enjoy the great situation. And if you're going to think, or if you think back about how it used to be, make, you know, laugh about it, joke about it, say, you know, hey, wasn't that awful, wasn't that funny? How awful was that? It was crazy, huh? Cuckoo, that was really funny. Just, you know, make light of it, make light of it, make light of it, because you're out of it. Full stop in the wow, you know, full stop in the wow is very important. You can slow down. Slowing down is okay. When you're in neither nor mode, you slow down, you can do a full stop in the wow. Pull off the side of the road, stop for a while. Good, you said, hey, I really don't feel like I'm in either or mode right now. And I don't really feel like I want to be pressured, so I'm going to pull off the side of the road. I'm going to pull off the freeway. I'm going to pull off. And just take a little break here to rest stop. My gosh, this morning, the stars in this. I came out and it's still dark and looking up. Wow, it's so clear. It's been a long time since I looked at the sky like that. And just, wow, stars everywhere. Venus was just very, very bright by a sort of semi-half moon, blazing, being a morning star, what they call the evening star. What's the morning star? It had to be Venus. It was blazing. Well, we don't look, we don't look so much at the stars anymore. It's been years. I mean, rarely do I ever even look at the sky. Usually you can't see so much light haze and pollution, light haze and everything. But very clear, beautiful morning this morning. Absolutely gorgeous morning in California. Ridiculously nice. Great day to be in the, sit down at the neither nor table, right? Sit down at the neither nor table. Get better food here, that's for sure. Not garbage here, not garbage food. So we'll see what happens. We'll see what I'm experiencing. I'm looking forward to it. You know, I'm looking forward to it. Just got to stay positive about it. And just see what happens. That's it from now. This has been a great breakthrough. Today, great breakthrough. As expected, October is the month for the great spiritual breakthroughs. Gotta go for it in October. Plain and simple. Gotta go for it. And that's what we're doing here. Okay. Remember, it's not either or. It's neither nor. Right now. Intermediate step. In a different boat. Full stop in the wow. Keep practicing. And stay tuned. That's it.